Hey everybody, this is Jorik. Welcome back to my channel. As you know, I'm an American living in Lisbon, Portugal. I'd like to talk to you about all things Portugal as well as our travels. And today's topic is one that I hope as you all travel, wherever it is, it could be to the next town over from you, to another state, country, you name it, that you take time in your travels to kind of take a left at Albuquerque, as the old Looney Tunes line was from Bugs Bunny. Something off the beaten path that wasn't necessarily on your trip or agenda. That's what we did recently. We were on the island of Rhodes, Greece, and we were in the town or village of Lindos. It's surrounded by incredible bays, has an Acropolis at the top like Athens. Just an amazing little place. And as we were walking through the winding streets and looking at the souvenir shops and getting some gelato and just enjoying this beautiful ancient city, we saw this lady off to the left, down a few feet from the regular shops. And she was working outside of what appeared to be her house. So we decided to take a left, walked towards her, and didn't realize, because it was off the beaten path, that her place is actually a museum that you can visit for free. And it's an 18th century home that her family has been in for generations. And it was so amazing. So this is a story about meeting Elena. So as we were walking through and seeing, it's basically one room with a lot of the family artifacts, photos and kitchenware and beds and mementos. There's an outdoor atrium area where there's olives growing in one tree. There's grapes growing right above you. It was kind of a neat experience to be able to see that. And what was interesting is there were a few other people that followed us. They'd poke their head in, they'd look around, and then within 10 seconds, they'd leave. We started asking questions. We thought this was very interesting. And Elena is elderly. I'm not sure how old she is, but she spoke enough English that we could communicate with one another. And she began to tell us the history of her family. And it was interesting because oftentimes we may think about it and go, okay, let's kind of get out of this conversation. We have other things to do. But because we were on vacation and we were just enjoying the road less traveled, we started asking her questions about each of the photos and some of the plates and kitchenware that were there and how old was this bed. And it was interesting that she had this huge smile that people were actually taking interest in her place because thousands of people a day walked right by it. It was a little off the main drag, if you will, but people would kind of look and keep walking. They wouldn't even walk down the pathway to get to her place. So I think she was tickled to have people take an interest. And what was so cool about it is that we get done and we bought a couple of postcards and mementos and we're getting ready to leave. And she grabbed us and put up her finger and she said, wait. And we're looking at one another going, okay, what's going on here? She went into an outdoor kitchen area, grabbed some waters for us, and gave us each what can best be described as a candied lemon type of dessert, which was fantastic and homemade by her. And so we got to sit in her outdoor area overlooking her garden. And it was so nice to be able to chat with her. And in that time, which only took about 15 minutes, there were a handful of other people that would kind of walk, do a quick look and turn around. She would get up to start telling them the story of her family and they wouldn't take an interest and leave. And it was in that moment that we realized that how much we enjoy being on trips and the highlights of our trips more often than not are not the main attractions, are not the big things that you see on websites, the top 10 lists. It's meeting the locals. It's having a drink or food or sharing and hearing stories from people that are from there, and let alone somebody whose family has been in this town for, I guess, 200, 300 years, she said. It was so incredible. And so the whole point of this video, other than to show you some of the photos of Elena and her home, is to just say, when you get a chance, do something off the beaten track. If you have a hidden gem, or if you're thinking, okay, I'm not sure if I should take a right or left, take both. Take the left, come back, and then take the right. Do something that's not necessarily on someone's top 10 list. Oftentimes you may find that it's those experiences and those conversations that end up being the highlights of your trip, as much or more so than the big ticket or the top three items. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I also hope that if you make it to Lindos, Greece on the islands of Rhodes someday, you go see Elena and hear her story. So thank you so much for watching and have a great day.